All right, guys, welcome back. It's thumbnail from the previous video, and this is the sketched version. So let's get started. Here I'm using Deleter Black ink, and I'm left-handed, so I'm gonna start from the bottom left and make my way up. So some of you guys might be wondering, like, did I use reference for any of this or for any of these illustrations? And I'm gonna be honest, I did not. So the illustration might not look very familiar because the details are my style and what I use to portray, like, realism. But yeah, let's talk about that. Like, when you're drawing or when you're inking the details, and you're inking the details like straight off from your imagination, it makes your illustration look abnormal. Like, it's not gonna be as good as, you know, say somebody who used reference for like the same illustration, because a lot of the details are coming from your imagination, and it's gonna be stuff that people have never seen before, so it's not gonna be very familiar. But the advantage to you know, doing details from your mind and from knowledge that you have accumulated over the years of drawing, it makes it more stress-free for you compared to if you were, you know, using reference. Because I know for me, like, when I'm trying to do something and I'm using reference, and, you know, my art doesn't look as good as the reference, it sort of irritates me because I'm trying to make it look like, you know, similar to the reference that I'm using. It makes it a little bit harder because you're trying to, you know, you're trying to comprehend what you're seeing, and then you're trying to put it down on the paper. But, you know, there are two ways to this. For some people it's easier if they use reference, but to each his own. For me, like, it's just more calm when I'm just, you know, inking the details straight out of my head. And I'm just trying to, you know, make it look like a tree. So I just use the details that that will make a tree look like a tree. That's just how I do it. And then for the rocks here, you see, like, I'm basically just adding shadow to these rocks just to make it look like rocks. But of course, in real life, the details are a whole lot different. Maybe not this much detail, but I like to add a lot of detail to everything. So while I was doing this, I was actually I was taking a lot of breaks. You know, I would ink for 30 minutes and then I would take a break for like an hour because I took like a 9 month break. So I haven't inked or drawn anything for like 9 months. I've just been working a lot, and I've been riding like motorcycles. So I haven't really drawn or inked anything. And whenever I came back and I decided to ink Again, I thought I was going to be a little bit rusty, but to my surprise, I was actually doing a lot more than what I used to do before I quit. I guess muscle memory really does play a big role. And every time I take a break or a long break and I come back, I tend to push myself, a little bit harder because I don't remember like my progress. I mean, I got other illustrations to look at and sort of compare, but at the same time, like, I don't really know like how to get back into that, that progress. So what I do is I just do a lot more just so I can push myself back up to the pace that I used to be at. But here you see I'm drawing like the leaves for this tree, and I should have stopped, but for some reason I kept going, and then it just sort of made this tree look kind of abnormal to me. I guess you live and you learn. My reasoning for all this detail is not because I'm a perfectionist. It's because I just know that like you can never finish an illustration. Like you're never complete. So that's why I go like and do as much detail as I can just so I can fool myself that yeah, I'm done, because it's a lot of work adding all these details. So when you put this much work on yourself, you sort of have this satisfaction that yeah, you have done a whole lot and that you should stop soon. But if I didn't want to stop, I could go back over this illustration and I could add tones just to make this illustration look more like, you're inside the woods, just to make it a little bit darker and not so bright, because it looks like this whole illustration is like the sun is just penetrating through like everything. But usually when you go inside the woods, it's fairly dark. Now, do I ever use reference when I do illustrations like this? Yes, I do. I try not to, but when I do, I kind of wing everything just to make it easier on myself. Just because whenever I use reference, I tend to be a little bit lazy because I don't like to try and make my artwork look like, something that I've seen before. And that's another reason why I try to, make my illustrations without reference, because, I like to look back at my illustrations and be like, wow, that's something I've never seen before, like in real life. But if it's an illustration composed of a ton of reference, I would look at the illustration and be like, oh yeah, that's from the park, or that's, the photo I found on Google and stuff like that. But with an illustration like this, I look back. If I was to look back like, 3 months from now, I'd be like, dang, how did I come up with this scenery, But yeah, I wasn't quite sure how I was gonna complete this because it just kept going on and on with, rocks and stuff like that. So I was very excited when I got to the trees because then, I'm near like the end. And I like doing trees a whole lot more than I like doing rocks. Because like with trees, I can add like as much detail as I want and not leave like a lot of white spots. And that's what I really liked to do back when I was in high school. I liked shading a lot, and I think that's helped me a lot when it comes to inking, because when you're doing stuff where you have to add a lot of detail, most of it's either just shading, but you know, with different sorts of lines. But yeah, I love shading, but now I don't ever shade with my pencil anymore. I barely draw with a pencil, like seriousness. I just do rough sketches and then I just ink them, and then that's when I do like the shading. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this. And if you guys have like any questions, just leave comments down below and I'll try to answer them or try to talk about them in my next illustration. But yeah, guys, this is it, the finished product. I hope you guys will stay tuned, and there'll be more to come. Thank you.